Hello anatomy colleagues, this is Dr. Alsup, and in this video we will be discussing the muscle compartments of the hand. And unlike in other compartments thus far, we are not going to really get into the specifics of the individual muscles or identifying those, as they typically work as units to work on some of the fine control that is found in the hand. So focusing more on the compartments or the units than the individual muscles, as that is how they are often discussed clinically. Now, some of the compartments are named after just one set of, or one muscle, so that will come up. But for the most part, we're just talking the compartments. I also want to note that these compartments are mostly composed of intrinsic muscles of the hand, which have both proximal and distal attachments entirely within the hand, but there are also extrinsic muscles that certainly affect the actions of the joints in the hand. So all those long tendons that we just discussed in the anterior and posterior compartments of the forearm, those long tendons will certainly be visible in the hand as well. Additionally, our focus will be on the palmar or anterior portion of the hand. So this is an anterior view. And all the views that we'll have from here on out will be anterior views, just different levels in terms of superficial or deep. And the reason that we're focused here is the majority of intrinsic muscles are located on this anterior or palmar side. And this makes sense. If you feel your palm region, your own palm region, you can feel squishier muscle there than what you feel on the back of your hand, which is mostly long tendon and bone. So most of these intrinsic muscles are on the anterior side. Looking superficially in the palmar region of the hand, I think the thing that sticks out to me most is this triangular white opaque region right here, which is the palmar aponeurosis. And this is a thickening of the deep fascia of the hand. You will have some tendons that will attach there, such as the palmaris longus. And the palmar aponeurosis is really there to protect the deeper structures, such as the nerves, arteries, and tendons that are located more in the central compartments of the hand. It also helps me personally split up the eminences, or those moundings of muscles. There is going to be a larger, more lateral thenar eminence and a smaller and more medial hypothenar eminence. The thenar eminence is associated with the first digit or the thumb. So this means that this is lateral. So these intrinsic muscles that are located right here in this thenar eminence is they're going to move the joints of the first digit. Whereas the hypothenar compartment is associated with the fifth digit, or the more medial digit, the little finger, and will move joints associated with the fifth digit. Now note, we are looking at a superficial view of these compartments, and there will be deeper muscles associated with each eminence. So we're looking at the superficial most muscles, but there are deeper muscles of both the thenar and the hypothenar eminence. Muscles in both of these compartments will flex, abduct, and oppose its associated digit. So either the first digit if thenar or the fifth digit if hypothenar. If you look at your own palm, you can get a pretty set location of where these eminences are, as they present as elevations or mounds under your first digit or under your thumb and your little finger or fifth digit. Moving to the central compartment of the hand, notice that the palmar aponeurosis has been removed in this dissection. And this is to be able to view some of the long tendons from the anterior forearm. So I see a tendon right here. I see a tendon right here. Some of them are a little bit occluded, but I see them kind of spread out throughout here. There'd be another one here associated. It's kind of blocked. And these are from the flexor digitorum superficialis and profundus muscles. Those tendons kind of stack on top of one another and will distally attach on either the middle or the distal phalange. Now notice these kind of worm-like muscles, which I'm putting an L next to, in this region. These are unique. These are lumbrical muscles, and these lumbrical muscles have a proximal attachment on the flexor digitorum profundus tendons. So they do not have a proximal attachment on bone. If you see muscle attached to tendon in the central compartment of the hand, you can definitively say you are looking at a lumbrical muscle. And you can see these really well here. Lumbrical, 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 right here attached to the flexor digitorum profundus tendons. You can also see deeper muscles, and notice you can see muscles where the thenar and hypothenar eminences are. So this is still the thenar eminence, and this is still the hypothenar eminence. We're just looking at the deeper muscles in that compartment. You also have an adductor pollicis, so adductor, not abductor, adductor, which even though it does affect the first digit, is not typically included in the thenar compartment. If you get all the way to the bone, which we can see here, you see the interossei muscles. So located in between the bones, so in between bones, interossei. There are dorsal and palmar interossei muscles. These right here are palmar interossei. I know I'm looking anteriorly here, or on the palmar side, because I can see the pronator quadratus right here, which we know is anterior. You can see a peak of the first dorsal interossei right here, kind of in between this lumbrical and the adductor pollicis. The reason you can see this dorsal interossei from an anterior view is because the first dorsal interosseous muscle is the largest interosseous muscle. So you can see it from both a posterior and an anterior view. The rest of the dorsal interossei are only visible from a posterior view, which we do not have here on this slide. All right, excellent. Those are the muscle compartments of the hand in a nutshell. Please take time to review these, and always feel free to reach out to me or any of my anatomy colleagues with any questions.